trim the yards off the wind!
Pull, pull for all your worth!
Captain's at the helm.
Unfurl, mates! Let's move! Crowd it all on! Douse the royals!
Reef the foreman!
Stunts out! Let's get moving!
Those Thompsons, gallants and royals!
Fire!
Get our dogs right!
On your mark, Captain!
Cruise up! Eat her sticks! Fire! Round on every inch of sail! Go for gallants and royals!
Keep out of her way! She will ram us!
Haul them in! Get off the wind! Fire! Cruise up! Handsomely!
Careful, Captain!
Fire! Haul in the stunts!
Waiting orders!
Tops, gallants, royals, studs! Stand on your feet!
Fetch dropping mines would curb her ability to
fire! Run. Get them aloft! Down all sail!
Bring it up there, sir! That'll wipe them out!
Fire! As much sail as you can!
Six, trip two!
Raise!
I said Hardy!
Raise!
Down to the ship, can we? Do not leave us
face
to face! All down and crew up!
Take them all in! Go!
Fire!
That was a rumble, by God. How do we fare?
A fine purchase, no mistake. Now, I think it's time to lay low and bribe our way back into secrecy.
Agreed. So, how do we get rid of this notoriety we've stirred up?
Money, my boy. A well-placed bribe to the right government official. See the military off your tail.
Right, let's do that. I'll need to meet these good Samaritans at some point.
Smart thinking.
Aloft, lads! Check those royal
high love she came, dressed all in white. Lowlands away. I dreamed my love came in my sleep.
Hey, friend. Want to go low profile?
You're a wonder, Kenway. You've a knack for this kind of work.
It ain't work if you love it. But I ain't doing this forever, lads. Only until I get enough coin to buy some land and influence back home.
Jesus, will you listen to your tripe? Still dreaming on about that strumpet back in England when you could have any better you wanted here and now.
Ah, such lofty goals for you gents. And here I thought I was in the company of scoundrels. Fine purchase today. What's the crew's mood?
All smiles and no teeth. And there's a few talking about meeting with Master Kidd to steal from a nearby plantation.
Plantation? It's ambitious.
Profitable too, if we can manage it.
Aye. It's a good idea.
Let's move!
Loose the mains, half sails!
More sail! All sail!
Stunsels, let's ride the squall!
Hey, boys! Out of just here!
I think we've lost them, sir.
Goodbye, very well. Goodbye, very well. marches, hear the yeomen say,
hurrah, me boys, we're homeward bound.
We're homeward bound to Liverpool town.
Goodbye, fare ye well, goodbye, fare ye well.
Where all of them duties, they will come down.
Hurrah, me boys, we're homeward bound.
And when we get to the Wallace gates,
goodbye, fare ye well. Goodbye, fare ye well.
Oh, Sally and Polly, for the flash men do wait.
Hurrah, me boys,
we're home and bound. Sir, to the and starboard! Lots of sir.
Well,
looks like
loot.
Goodbye, fare ye well. Goodbye, fare ye well.
Oh, here he comes, Johnny, with 40 months pay.
Hurrah, me boys, we're home and bound.
Well, meet these like guys, and we'll ready
human flocks
your
bell. Captain. Seems to be survived.
Shorten sail! Get off the squall!
To his wheel, race Mary
Ellen!
Stands out! Let's get moving! Toast the gallants and royals!
Bring it all, sir! Gammon tight!
Hands in the water!
Why, look! It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet 10 times the demon his father was.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that'd earn you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands. And he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him, and he'll lead you straight to your prize.
It is hearty molasses and raw cane, that's a given.
It gladdens me to hear you're saying so. But despite the waywardness of your enterprise here, I understand that you are men of discernment. Burford, Manning, to me. We've done with this place.
Aye, sir. What's our course?
We'll return to the plantation and there take stock of our inventory. Good harvest.
You might not be so loud, sir. This isn't anything like a friendly fort, Ken.
Nonsense, man. I had a delightful conversation with a chap just now. We came to quite an understanding.
As you say, sir.
All understanding, my boy.
I'm not gonna wait around.
Captain, you have the look of a man crafting a bold idea. A look I've seen before.
You mark well, Addy. I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping there, and it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea.
Who's all? Party like!
Patrol these waters closely, Captain.
Hold on it. There's trouble afoot.
I see them.
This man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantations, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked a plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled? Something else?
Cane juices. It's a hard process making sugar. Dangerous, too. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like, toiling on a plantation day and night?
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers that crush the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, it was time to boil away the water from the sugar. This we did in tatches made of copper. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin will stick like birdlime and burn on, leaving a terrible scar.
It's a risk to anchor too close. The soldiers roving the plantation would catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackal.
Why such disarray?
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get pickled? On duty?
Don't bother, sir. We have everything sorted.
You'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed here, young man. By pirates, if my eyes were me. Though the ship was uncommonly large for such rascals. Certainly wasn't slavers, though. Not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch. And keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man! You've a job to do!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
For God's sake, what the hell is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're piss drunk and barely able to stand?
Forgive me, sir. I am fit and able. If I see any strangeness about, you'll hear the bell ringing straight away, I promise.
Speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dog?